Is that message again? Oh, it's telling me that I might have watermarks in my recording. Oh, that's fine. That's fine. I work around them. So, red flags in role playing. Here we go.
Hi, I'm James from Chaosium. I sat down with Lynn and we talked about red flags in role playing,
Did you
things
know?
that you can notice from yourself or from other players that
From
might give you
yourself?
a little note that you might
Am I a red flag in this game session?
want to adjust something in your game to make sure that everybody is having the best time possible at the table.
How about don't be a Jew hater at a table? How about that for a change?
I'll jump across to that interview in just a moment, but first, remember to subscribe to the Chaosium YouTube channel. It helps us out and it lets us make more content like this. Thanks.
The one of the main ones is obviously someone either deliberately or inadvertently hogging the spotlight. This is supposed to be a collaborative storytelling experience, so you don't want one person monopolizing the GM's attention, directing what everybody else is doing, ordering people around. And I mean, most of the time, it's usually because people are just so enthusiastic that they get a bit carried away. They're enjoying themselves, solving the mystery. They're enjoying playing their character. They're not necessarily thinking about it. So, a good thing for a GM to keep an eye on is just to make sure that everybody's getting their moment in the sun, basically. I mean, you do get some players who are just very quiet and they may not want to speak up, they may not necessarily have the.
What if all the players don't talk and the GM is doing all the talking? Who's hogging the spotlight then?
Confidence to speak up. Excuse me. So they may not necessarily have the confidence to speak up, but the GM should just try and involve them. They should specifically ask them, you know, is there anything your character wants to do? Does your character have a thought on this? You know, just things like that. But try and do it so that you're also not just singling them out, because if they are shy and unsure, really flashing the spotlight on them is possibly going to also just make them freeze like a rabbit in the headlights. So it's really just that balance of being aware and trying to encourage everybody to contribute in a way that suits them.
I think that's a good point. You want to strike the balance correctly. Speaking of striking a balance and trying not to do too much of a good thing, do you
How about just do round robin, where the players take turns saying what their character is doing? Everyone has a chance to say something in the game. How come that's not done?
think that there are any red flags that emerge from you kind of coming from a good place and like an overzealous position? One of the things that I've run into a few times is that I learned early on that it's exciting to not rely too heavily on social checks, a persuade check or an intimidate check to roll out a scene if people want to role play. But at the same time, you don't want to throw that too much at people because some people like having the dice there. They don't want to role play out every scene and it's a good resource. You don't want to take that away. Are there things like
How do we know? How do we know that people don't like to role play and they'd rather just roll dice? How do we know this? Are the players that don't say anything in these games, in these game sessions on YouTube, the players that are quiet the whole time? Have they said that they prefer not to role play in a role playing game? Has anyone said this?
like that, where going too far, even if it's from a good place, can cause a problem.
Well, yes, and it's part of learning your trade. You know, as a GM, no one's expecting you to be perfect at it out of the gate. It's something that requires practice. We always learn more from mistakes than we do from getting it right the first time. So, you know, don't be afraid to not quite be perfect when you're doing it. Just make a note of it. Remember for next time. If you do get a bit over enthusiastic, that's actually really quite nice because it shows that you're invested in the story too. And I think sometimes people forget that the GM's there to have fun as well. you know, it's a lot of work being a GM. It's a lot of responsibility. And if you've got nice players, they will appreciate that and you know, meet you partway with the collaboration. But don't beat yourself up, basically, if you don't get it right first time. We all make mistakes, even though we've been doing this for years.
I want to seize on something you said. If you make a mistake, you can note it down. You can try again for next time. If you do make a mistake and you've got it noted.
How do you know if you made a mistake during a game? How do you know you made a mistake? Is this when somebody dies in the game? Or is it something like you misspoke and a character rolled a number and you said, okay. You didn't really check the chart, the result chart. So you gave out an okay instead of no, you don't.
Down. What are some of the things you can do in your downtime, in the space between the sessions, to make sure that you try and correct something? Is it always just talk to your
alone time? I'm going to fix my mistakes alone. I know what to fix. I have alone time where I know what to what mistakes to fix. You know, be like Victor Von Doom and just constantly have inner thoughts about your mistakes and who to blame for your mistakes in life.
Players, are there any particular tips that you have to try and improve your games in between sessions?
Yeah, check with your players afterwards. Have sort of like what we would call in LARPing a debrief. So at the end of the session, if you've got time, just have a quick chat with your players and go, you know, how did that go? Did this work? Did that work? Or, you know, well,
Yeah, she's right there. You should always talk after the game session. Yep. Man, it's been a while since I heard some good advice on YouTube. It's been a while.
Didn't quite get that right. I misremembered a rule and I just thought we'd go with it for this bit, but it should have been this. You know, do you want to go with the actual version next time? Are you happy with it working this way? You know, just talk to your players. I mean, if it is something that you misremembered.
Yeah, usually you make a ruling on the fly because you don't know the rule exactly. Or some situation came up and you just made a ruling on the fly for it. At the end of the session, you guys can always look up in the book what you're really supposed to do. And that's it, you know. Get good. Someone posted a comment on one of my videos. Get good.
The rule, you just go back to the rule books and refresh your memory and make a little note so you've got it for next time. And that's really all you can do, is just talk to people, make sure that they're enjoying themselves.
Yeah, the point of all that is you don't stop the game. So you can go look in a book to find out what the rule says. You don't do that. You know, if... I don't know. It's just you don't stop the game for something that's so minor. If it's something you can make a ruling for on the fly, just do the ruling. I mean, it's nothing major, obviously. I mean, if you're suffering from OCD or ADHD or you're autistic or you're just retarded, if you're one of them idiot savants, just, find a different hobby.
That nothing is upsetting them, that they understand that if you did make a mistake, it was a genuine mistake. You're not trying to do anything to deliberately penalize somebody, you know, say.
Okay, so I'm waiting for the red flag part. Where's the red flag part?
You'd ask them to, you'd give them a penalty to dive for something that you shouldn't have done, that you're not, it was just, you know, a genuine cock up, if you'll pardon the French, rather than you're deliberately doing that because it's that particular player.
As someone with the benefit of a lot of experience in the role-playing scene, I'd love to ask you something that I know that a lot of my friends, particularly those who are new to the hobby, run across quite a bit. And that is when they have a player or, you know, a a GM, if they are a player, who is displaying a bunch of red flags and then not addressing them, if they have somebody in their group who is causing active problems. And I know a lot of people don't really know how to address that, and it's tough. It's not an easy thing.
Give an example of a problem player, please. Link, or it never happened.
Thing to address. As somebody who has been playing for a long time, does it get easier? Is there a magic solution that presents itself?
Sadly, no. It's never easy to have those discussions. It's really not, usually because you're playing with friends. So obviously, if you're playing with friends, you don't want to.
Well, some people are playing with the general public. So that could cause all kinds of problems.
Create a fuss. You don't want to create bad feeling at the table. But the whole point is that if you don't address it, you are going to end up with bad feeling at the table. The easiest, well, not the easiest way, because it's never an easy conversation.
Just ghost that person. Don't invite them. Don't tell them when the next session is.
Is for the GM to quietly take the player to one side and have a word with them, because they may not realize what they're doing. You hope in most cases that they don't.
The GM says, I should have vetted you. I knew I should have vetted you, but you're someone's friend, so we let you in, but you're a fucking loser. You're not coming back to the game. Goodbye.
You know, maybe if it's the players might want to have a word with their fellow player if they think they're causing an option.
Now, players don't change. They become more so. Just get rid of them. Just be thankful you found the problem quickly.
You know, if the GM is behaving in a particular way the players don't like, that the players may wish to nominate a player to talk to them, because it's usually easier to deal with these things to start with on a one-on-one basis.
She's your girlfriend. You talk to her.
Basis, rather than it having a whole group talking to one person, so that person doesn't feel like they're being got at, if you know what I mean. But sometimes, sadly, people's play styles just don't mesh. And if you need to walk away...
Well, this was a non-topic. I'm not surprised, but Chaosium has a very boring RPG system. It's very boring. So they're just coming up with non-issues for their video topics. Okay.